kindness in the 21st century. I'm always the 21st century. I'm the up-to-date person. She always put me on the 21st century. And my scripture is different from yours. My scripture is John 3:16. Most of us are ought to know because we've been in church. And we've been around to Sunday school where we've heard John 3:16. And John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Now, when you're thinking about kindness, we're going to break down what kindness is. Kindness means, as according to Webster, the dictionary, quality or state of being kind or kindly. It can be courtesy, favor, grace, indulgence, mercy, service, compassion, feeling, or heart. Under favor, it means friendly regard for another. Right? The act of approval or being approved, effort on one's behalf. Now, from what you got all shared, Sister Bell, Sister White, and Sister Fanny, the Shunammite woman, she took the effort. She didn't have to. Because she was with her own people. She had her own stuff.
All right.
She could have minded her own business and not even bother with the stranger that was passing by her house and on his journey. But because of her kindness, she had feeling in her heart. And she regarded his need. And she saw it. He needs a place to stay. He in this country. He on our side of the town a lot, you know. So we need to do something for this man. Now John 3:16 says this about the Father that has loved the whole entire world, has everything and everybody in it. God so loved the world. Before we was born, in the twinkle in our mama or eye and the glistening in our dads, God already loved us, the world, that he gave is only, he only had one son. He only got one son. There isn't enough. There is no, just like the word said, there's no other God before him, none beside him, none coming after him. There's just one Jesus, the redeemer of the whole world. There's just one Jesus that actually gave his life. There's just one Jesus that we, whose name we're supposed to believe in. There's just one Jesus whose name is able to save us. So, God gave his only son, only begotten son, that whoever believes in him, and this was the kindness that he extended way back in Genesis 3:15, when he told the woman, he told the serpent that the seed of the woman was going to bruise your head and you going to bruise his feet. But he gonna crush your head. That's what God actually told him. Right. Way back then. Then John 3:16 said that whosoever in the world, whichever one of us, because God gave his approval on him, said, "This is the way I'm gonna redeem you. This is the way I'm gonna bring you back to be mine. This is my approval. This is the way his effort to be the savior of the world made it possible." That was the kindness that was extended to mankind. Because God, being a just God, and I heard it once say, his mercy cried out when his judgment said they all need to die. Oh. His mercy said, the seed of the woman go crush your head. You might bruise his heel, but the seed of the woman, and that was Jesus. Whosoever believed in him should not perish, but had. That means being cut off without remedy. Cut off without any price. Cut off. Just lost. Just lost. Ain't got no hope, no kind of care, no regard, no nothing. But God. principles, his attribute. That's they say his attribute is kindness. That's part of that fruit of the Spirit. So we know that's an attribute of God.
Yes.
Kindness. His loving kindness is better than life. His loving kindness is extended to us. Limitation 3:21 says this. I'm going to give it the 21st verse. He said, this I recall to my mind. It was Jeremiah. Therefore have I hope. It is the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed.
Hallelujah.
Because his compassion.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Woo! This is what he did in John 3:16. Because his compassion failed not. Way back there at the beginning when man failed in the garden, his kindness was ever extended toward us. He said, for God's, I mean, you think about that. Everybody, he knew before we even got here that there are going to be some that are going to heal. That's why the word said, whosoever.
Yes.
Whosoever. Because everybody ain't going to, you give an invitation for something, and you give it to a whole lot of people. You're going to have some people who say they're going to go, and they ain't going to show.
Right.
You're going to have some people who say, maybe, and they